Hey guys, it's Saturday today and it's pretty late. Today was supposed to be my free day because I had planned to do Dungeons and Dragons all day today. But we were done a lot earlier than I expected and I actually have some time left over today, so I decided to work on my comic. And yeah, I'll show you guys what I'll do today. Alright guys, I'm here back with another voiceover part. I spent this entire session actually doing the main sketches for my comic. As you can see, I do this traditional. I cut an A4 paper in half and I just work in a vertical format, taping the pages under each other. And here I do my final sketches actually. So at a certain point I will scan these in and I will do the line art directly on top of these sketches. Why I do this? I just really prefer working on actual paper instead of working on my tablet screen. So that's just a preference, and you should search what works for you and try to work in that way. So I haven't seen anyone else do it in this way, but hey, you know, maybe this also works for you and feel free to try it out. This week I haven't been really working a lot on the comic. I have been working a ton on commissions and they're slowly slowing down a little bit, so I hope I can work more on the comic next week. But I still managed to get some stuff done, so yeah, I'm not unsatisfied with what I did this week. I do notice that this process of me drawing on just normal paper and sketching everything out here is a little bit slow and it takes quite a while, so that's maybe one reason why you wouldn't want to choose this process over just sketching digital. So of course I'm not just sketching out of my head and making things up the way I go. I have my script laying next to me, that's the script that I made in the last video. And I also have the thumbnails that I made based on the script laying next to me. I've been watching some YouTube videos about making webcomics and making webtoons. And I found some really helpful videos that actually really helped me with making the script and making the thumbnails. An amazing channel that I found not too long ago is Walter Ostley. I'll leave a link to his channel in the description, and I kind of used his way of thumbnailing. So he does it directly digital, but I just folded an A4 size of paper a couple of times double. You can actually see it now here in the top left corner of the video that I have my thumbnails right there. So yeah, I'll leave the link to that video, and I just did it exactly the way that he did it, but then traditional. I really like this way of doing the thumbnails vertical directly in the scrolling format, as you can see. Because that will be easier for you to see the comic before it's actually made, and it'll be easier to decide if you need some extra panels or if you need to add some more spacing or if something is not clear in the comic. So yeah, that's why I really like this method. In between working on Iconic, I'm actually also working on a Dungeons & Dragons campaign. And here you can see some of the characters that I'm making and some of the monsters. And some of the NPCs, I think. Dungeons & Dragons, making your own campaign and playing it with your friends is like a great way to practice your writing and practice your character design. So yeah, thought this would be fun to show. So, at the time of recording this voiceover, I haven't decided yet how long the episodes will be. I'm just working on the story in chronological order, and I haven't decided where the episode breaks will be yet. I think I'll make each episode between 15 and 25 panels long. I think 30 to 40 panels might be a bit too big of an episode for me to be able to finish it each week. But I'll kind of have to figure out how long it takes me to make episodes and how long... more so how much faster I'll get, because I probably think I'm still really slow in making episodes, and I don't really know yet how all the characters look like entirely, so I spent a lot of time still on world building and on designing, and I also still make a ton of mistakes. I kind of have to figure out how long it takes me to make an episode, and then I'll see how long I will make the episode, I guess. But yeah, I can already see myself getting faster, actually. I already know a bit now how I want to draw Rudy, so that gets easier with every panel. And now I'm slowly warming up to Amy too. So slowly I'm learning and it's getting better. I've been drawing for about 1.5 hours, and as you can see, my desk is a total mess. I think I'm gonna take a break and maybe I'll draw some more, but I'm guessing this will be it for tonight. Hey guys, today is Sunday. I've done my morning exercise and I've just taken a shower. And it's a really beautiful day today, and I think I'm gonna go outside and see if there's not too many people in the park, and I'll see if I can do some work on my iPad there. So, as you can hear, I took out the natural sounds that were under the video, even though I normally quite like those sounds and keep them under the video whenever I can. But it started to get really windy and yeah, it was just too loud and too distracting, so I couldn't choose the natural sounds that were under the video, sadly. Also, I couldn't stay long in the park. Yeah, I'm gonna tell you guys why in a second. I'm back home again. I went to the university park instead of the normal park because it was quite busy there. And well, I rather sit alone because otherwise people will watch. And to, yeah, with these times it's good to avoid busy places. So yeah, when I started drawing, I quickly noticed that I forgot to scan one page, and that page I needed rather soon, so instead of the line art that I wanted to do, I did two panels line art, and then I colored some panels of the previous episode. So now I'm back at home and I'll scan that page that I need, and I'll do some line art back here. Yeah, so this was the page that I needed. There's still my old scans underneath. And I just scan at 300 dpi, but maybe that's not really necessary because it's webtoon format and it's gonna be small anyways. So, now that's scanned, I can work on the rest of the line art for the next episode. I have a small clip of me placing the loose panels in the right place in the comic before I actually line art them. Yeah, this, I could have done this already on the paper, but I just thought that was a waste of paper and I wanted to draw efficiently all the panels right under each other. And now I'm actually deciding the spacing. I might still change things later if I think I need somewhere more spacing, or if I need to make it a little bit more fast-paced, I'll remove some of the spacing. So that's something that I do right now. And usually I try to do this for all the panels of the episode in one go before I start actually working on the line art, just to make things clearer for myself. And yeah, I usually don't do it for multiple files, I'll just do it for one file, even though an episode might take some more files. As you can see, I was moving to the couch. I just was feeling the weekend and I wanted to be very chill and not work at my desk. So as you saw earlier, I went outside a lot to work in the park whenever there weren't people there. And I also usually work on the couch whenever I can work on my iPad. So yeah, just is way more comfortable. I think that maybe I was working on this comic, this episode, for a little bit too long in one go. Since I finished his line art, I noticed that a lot of the proportions were off. I fixed those proportions after this video was done, so you can see me actually fixing the proportions. But yeah, I have thought of going back into the first and the second episode and fixing the proportion mistakes I made there, but I'm deciding not to go back and fix things that I did wrong earlier. I think that if you go back too many times and fix all the mistakes that you're making, then the comic will probably never get finished. Maybe if I am really far into the comic, I'll redo the first couple of episodes. But for now, I just want to move forward and not care too much about the mistakes that I'm making. As I also was saying, I'm really not confident yet with the proportions of my characters, and I'm making a ton of mistakes with how they look like. And if you look very closely, then probably the proportions fluctuate a lot in between the panels. But hey, I just hope that I'm going to get better in this and that slowly my proportions will become a little bit more stable. I also am not really happy yet with some of the character designs and some of the ways that I draw things. And I think I will slowly try to update those things. Like, I'm not happy yet with the way that I color most of the comic, but I will not try to keep it really consistent. I'll just slowly work out how I want things to look like, and then I'll slowly along the episodes change things until it finally looks exactly how I want to. I used to worry a lot about consistency, and I used to worry that if the colors aren't consistent in every episode, then people will notice and they will complain. But if I want to keep things 100% consistent, that's not going to happen. Let's be honest. I make mistakes, I do things differently, I change my mind about things. Not everything is going to be consistent, and if I will forcefully keep myself doing the same mistakes over and over again just to keep it consistent, then I think that's really counterproductive for my art career. So yeah, I'm slowly going to change things until it is how I like it. And That may mean that things are going to change in the comic. If you're used to Rudy having a banana-colored hair, then maybe in the future it's more going to be a natural blonde, because I like it that way a little bit more, but I just haven't figured out exactly the way how I can keep that color. Because it doesn't always look right next to the other colors, and then I tweak it a little bit. I'm just not very good at that stuff yet, but that's just something that I still have to learn and have to get better in. And that's how you grow. So this isn't really my first comic, but it is my first 100% my own project, so it's not for school, it's not for someone else. And that since it's that personal, I want to be perfectionistic about it, but I really shouldn't be, because that only makes growing as an artist difficult. Yeah, but still, because it is my first 100% self-made project, I also shouldn't really set the bar too high. Because I have many more comics to make in the future. And you know what? I can be better later on. I don't have to be good now. It all comes with time. And with that, we're at the end of the video. I hope you liked watching me draw this part of the comic. I know there's not a lot of color in it, so I hope it was still kind of entertaining to watch. I upload videos every Wednesday, so if you want to see more of me, be sure to subscribe. And it would help me a lot if you could also leave a like and a comment. And I hope to see you in the next video. Bye!